Welcome back, everyone. After stirring the pot a little bit, in my last video on Column Raise, talking about the pros and cons, I figured let's just keep the ball rolling and let's talk about what DJ speakers you should buy. Because I get a lot of questions every day. One of the biggest questions, and I mean literally every day I get the questions around, what speaker should I buy? Is this speaker better than that one? How many watts of speakers do I need to handle this many people? How many people can this system handle? So all you DJs out there, I'm gonna answer them in this video. So the speakers you should buy don't exist. Because as much as you would like to think, there is no real answer to what speakers you should buy. There are recommendations I could give of X speaker brand and such models of speakers and so and so forth. But that would be based on my opinion. Ultimately, the speaker that you should choose should be based on your opinion. So you need to do your own research and your own thinking to figure out what speakers are best for you. And with that said, here are my 8 points for things you should be thinking about when buying speakers. Point number one, the technical side, the specs. And guess what? Specs don't mean sh** anymore. Watts of speakers is never accurate because there's this thing called RMS and peak, and manufacturers can literally slap 1,000 watts on a speaker that's really 200 watts and get away with it. SPL is a better measurement, but SPL levels can be artificially inflated, or max dB levels. Those can be artificially inflated by companies as well, especially if they're not telling you how they measured it, or in a lot of cases they're actually calculating it, so it's a estimated guess of how loud the speaker can get, not a real world value. So in terms of specs, it's pretty much impossible to compare apples to oranges online. It's just not possible anymore. Point number two deals with your ears and my ears. Every one of you guys watching this video, including myself, have a different pair of ears, and you have a different taste in music, and you have a different taste in what you think a speaker should sound like. Now, some people might overlap with common opinions on speakers, but 9 times out of 10, the way that you want to hear your speakers is not the same way that I want to hear it, and not the same way that Joe, John, or Barr, or anybody else wants to hear their speakers. It's all completely different. Point number three goes off of point number one and point number two, and that is that every speaker out there sounds different. Even if the speakers are at the same SPL or loudness, that's a terrible term, loudness, they will sound different. Even if you're comparing, say, A speaker and B speaker, an EV speaker and a JBL speaker, and they can produce the same amount of volume, they're both like, they can both pump out 127 decibels, like the same loudness, they're gonna sound different. So in saying that speakers sound different and that you have different ears than me, you need to try your hardest, and this is point number four, to go demo speakers before you purchase them. You need to hear them in person. Speakers are one of the most expensive things we purchase as DJs, and you should know anything and everything there is about that speaker before you purchase it. And don't feel bad about yourself if you did purchase a speaker before listening to it. I've definitely done it multiple times, TurboSound IP300s maybe. But I know one of the biggest questions people are gonna ask is, how do I get my hands on it? How do I go demo these speakers? Well, there's things like Guitar Center, music stores, other DJs. Other DJs are a huge resource right there. And even just like events that you're at, you might go to someone else's wedding or a different party, go notice what speaker system they have and note how it sounds to you. And you can note if I like this or if I don't like this. Or maybe you'll just run into the speakers that you were wanting to demo and listen to out in the wild. Now that's a rare case unless you're looking to hear like a QSC K12 or an EV Evolve 50, because like 90% of the DJs out there have those. Personally, for the last year, I've been looking at buying like some Martin Audio dual 18 subwoofers and some tops. And straight up, I'm not gonna even come close to putting money down until I rent one of them and actually take it out to an event and see how it does for me. All right, we're gonna switch it up a little bit here with point number five, and that is application. Knowing the application that you're trying to achieve with the speakers that you want to buy has to be one of the top priorities you need to consider. What is the average size of my events? What's the biggest event I want to do? What's the smallest event I want to do with this size speakers? Are most of my events indoor? Are most of my events outdoor? What sorts of methods do I have to transport it? Am I using a two-door car? Am I using a four-door car? Do I have a full-size trailer? What is my restrictions on weight and being able to lift stuff? If I'm older, if I have back problems, is that something I need to consider? Do I always bring a roadie, or is this gonna take a big strain on my back over years to come? These are things you need to be considering in terms of your application and how you apply these speakers in your actual business. Just for example, we got speakers like the EV ETAX and the JBL SRX series. These are big, these are heavy, these are bulky speakers. They're gonna require some serious transportation, the ability to be able to lift heavy objects. They're gonna take up a lot of room. Yeah, they're just big and bulky and they're heavy. But on the plus side, they're gonna be able to handle very large events. Now, countering that, you could buy something a lot lighter, like an EV Evolve 50 or an RCF Evoc 8, which is going to be a lot lighter, a lot easier on your back, take up a lot less space, and it will be perfect for smaller events. Moving on to point number 6, and that is be smart, be logical. Be smart. And what I'm talking about is be smart in terms of a business sense. We are DJs. We are out here to try and make money. At least most of us are. This is a business. This is a career path. So you need to be mindful of some things, like where you're actually at in your career. Are you a beginner, an intermediate, a pro, an expert? You've been doing this for like 30 plus years. What is your average event going for, and how much can you reasonably afford to spend on a new speaker or a new system or just your first set of speakers? Just some personal opinions here. I feel like I have to throw that before everything I say now. Just some personal opinions here. I don't think a beginner DJ should be considering a $6,000 EV ETX or a JBL SRX rig. Maybe consider a more affordable system for your first ever DJ system at more around like $1,000 to $2,000. But yeah, be relatively smart with the amount of money that you're going to be spending on this new set of speakers in terms of your business. Just be smart. And this is kind of just reiterating all the points 1 through 6 that I've already mentioned, but I needed to throw it out there because just because it is popular and that someone else uses it does not mean that it's going to be something that you want and that you need. You really need to make sure it's a smart decision. In fact, if you noticed, I actually did this sort of thing and figured out what is the best decision for me with my wedding setups recently. I was using for a while there at the beginning of the year, I was using just 2 JBL SRX 815Ps for my weddings. And then I switched back to an older system that I had been using prior with the 2 JBL 15-inch subs and the 12-inch tops. And that's because points 1 through 6 led to that being a better decision for me. Personally, my ears just like the fuller sound with dedicated subs that could go lower with the PRX rig versus just the SRX tops. And another benefit to that was the fact that we didn't have to lift 63-pound speakers onto speaker stands. We just had to lift the 30-pound 712s now. All right. This brings me to my final point, and that is point number 8, and this is all about buying when you actually go to make your purchase. MSRP, sticker pricing, the price you see on Amazon and that you see listed online is not the price you should be paying. Sorry to any of my dealers out there that are watching this video in advance, but guys, if you see a speaker online listed for $1,000, that does not mean that the dealer will not sell it to you for cheaper. This is very similar if any of you have ever gone to a car dealership to purchase a brand new car. The dealership that owns all the cars, or the dealer that is selling these speakers, is not allowed to list anything lower than the sticker price. They cannot put on there anything lower without the manufacturer, the car manufacturer, or the speaker manufacturer saying otherwise. And anyone that's purchased the car knows that you decide on a car and then you go into the dealership and you negotiate a lower price. You can do this same sort of logic with speakers on a lower scale. Now, DJs, unlike just buying one car, a speaker dealer is not gonna really be willing to negotiate if you're only buying one speaker. You really need to be buying like two speakers and like two speakers and covers, or buying like four speakers and buying all the covers and sub poles. The more you can put in the deal, in the bundle for the dealer to give you, the more wiggle room that dealer's gonna have to negotiate with you. So buy in bulk is what I'm trying to say. And that actually is a side tip for anyone that's trying to buy any types of gear out there. If you bundle in a lot of stuff, like say you're looking to buy like 12 uplights and cases for those uplights, contact a dealer, because they're probably going to be willing to negotiate a little bit compared to that MSRP sales list price. But yeah, guys, those were my 8 tips and things that you should consider when looking to buy new speakers. First off, specs don't mean everyone has different ears. Everyone hears sounds differently. This leads into you really should go out and demo these speakers so that you know what you're getting into. Application means everything. Make sure you know what sorts of application you're trying to achieve with your speaker system. Be smart and be logical in terms of price, in terms of what speakers you're looking to buy, something that makes sense for you in terms of your business and where you're at in your stage of growth. Don't just buy a speaker system because someone else said it's good. Buy something that you actually hear and that you actually like and you actually enjoy. And lastly, remember, MSRP pricing and online sticker pricing is not the price that you should be paying. Create a bundle, contact a dealer, get yourself a better deal, purchase what sound system that you are looking at getting. But yeah, one thing I'm actually considering doing is doing an update to the top beginner speaker recommendations that I have for all you beginners out there. Look for that to be coming, but my first initial video is like super old and dated now. So I need to make an update to that video. But anyways, guys, like always, I hope you guys enjoyed this little bit of educational content. If you did, be sure to slap a like on this video. Remember to subscribe for all sorts of new amazing content, including gig logs, educational stuff, reviews, badass opinions. But yeah, guys, keep them records spinning, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.